What up, YouTube? It's time to brew some beer. All right, that's not 100% true. I'm not brewing beer today, but today I am making a hard cider. How I'm going about doing this is the super easy way. I've got 5 gallons of this apple cider blend. This is Sugar Bee brand. I was just strolling through the store, I think it was a Harris Teeter, and I saw this stuff. Picked it up because what are you looking for if you're trying to make hard cider? You don't want preservatives. And when I looked at this one, I hadn't seen this brand. It looked like one of them fancy dancy brands. A lot of the big name brands have the potassium sorbate that you don't really want. This one, no preservatives, 100% juice. I'm gonna put this stuff in here. I'm gonna check the starting gravity and see if I need to add some brown sugar to bring it up to where it'll give me a good alcohol content at the end of this. And we'll go from there, pretty simple. I got my star sand in here, sanitizing this guy. Dump out the excess and start the complex process of debottling. I'm gonna call it debottling. It's the opposite of bottling. I know, that's fancy. That's really sweet. And it's really sweet. Ooh. Which is pretty good considering what I'm trying to do with this. All right, let's check the gravity of this. Boom. I'm happy about this. We're at 1.052 right out the gate. Wonder if I should add any brown sugar to it. We're not gonna add any sweeteners. 1.052 right out the gate, we're gonna firm it. I'm surprised, I'm pleasantly surprised. I mean, tasted it was pretty sweet, but we're gonna go ahead and firm with this. We're not gonna add any brown sugar to it. This stuff is thick. We're using Safe Cider AB1. This is a balanced yeast for ciders. This is my first year trying a cider specific yeast. Normally what I use is I use a champagne yeast, which is what I was told to do when you're trying to make a hard cider, that it would work well for making hard ciders. And the three batches that I did with champagne yeast, it turned out pretty good. I'll be interested to see how well this one does. Like I said, nothing fancy. I'm gonna put this in and fermentation is complete. So I'm ready to get this hard cider out of the fermenter and into the keg. I've had star sand sitting in here to sanitize everything, including the line that's in here. I'm gonna throw in the hose barb and spigot that goes on here. I've already sprayed a little bit of star sand up in there just to make sure everything is sanitized before we rack. We finished out at 0.998. And I gave it a taste, it's dry, which is what I would expect. I expected this to be dry. I wasn't sure how much of the sweetness would carry over because the other hard cider that I did, I added brown sugar to it in order to bring up the starting gravity. And the thing I did notice when that one finished out is that not all of the brown sugar really fermented out, so it did come off a little bit sweeter, which some people like a little bit of a sweetness to their hard cider. That'd be perfect for you. Put a little brown sugar in there because it's not gonna all ferment out. I'm gonna fill this keg up, and just like the rest of my brews that you guys have seen, I'm gonna put this under 25 PSI. And just let it sit in the kegerator until it hits the carbonation level that I want. Once I'm pulling off samples and it tastes good, I'll dial it down or hide cider. I like them pretty bubbly. So I think I might go on the higher, maybe 18 PSI for serving pressure. Balance it out right there. cup carbonation level to where we want it. So now I'm gonna drop this down, let it stabilize, cut off the feed, back this out. This is burp it to zero it. And we'll bring this up to, what do we want to do here? We'll do 18. Very simple recipe, finished out at 7.1% ABV. And I know normally I would let you guys know, like, hey, I love this one, I'm gonna make it again. It's very, very simple. It's not bad, it's just plain. If I do it again the same way, with the same apple cider to begin with, I will definitely flavor it. I do think, because it was so easy to actually ferment it out, I do think that I will use this again, but I will be flavoring it, because right now it's just a very simple dry cider, which some people like. Right now, I am in the minority. Everybody else who's tasted this likes it. And I would say it could just be my preference that when I'm drinking a hard cider, I want it to just have a little bit of sweetness to it, just a touch. It is a straight, basic, simple cider. Putting in like a splash of a sweet red wine, it actually gives it a more drinkable flavor for me. It makes the color go all to craziness. But that was my simple cider recipe. First time I've tried it that way with that particular brand. I was happy with how easy it fermented out and how clean it fermented out. If you guys have any recommendations or anything like that from people out there in the brewing community who do more hard ciders, please hit them up in the comments, because I'm definitely looking to expand on my flavor profile for having hard ciders on tap. Thank you guys for watching. Keep brewing.